Welcome. In this video, we can discuss about Hive high availability. So we have seen a steady adoption of Hive service among our customers. Okay. So due to this increase in demand, so we need to make sure like the performance and availability of Hive is not compromised. So if you look into the Hive high availability part mainly, so we need to focus these parts. Okay, so one is underlying database, so it can be MySQL, Oracle, Postgres or any relational database. So we need to make sure the availability of the service at all the time. So we can use any one of the high availability feature that this database support. Then we need to make sure the zookeeper service is highly available because the zookeeper depends on this Hive service. Then Hive Metastore server and Hive server too. So in this video, I will walk you through the how to implement the high availability for Hive Metastore server. That is the third part number three. So this is my cluster and which is hosted in Amazon AWS and it is having one master and three nodes. And if you look into the Hive service detail, so go to the instances and these are the services. One Hive Metastore server and Hive server 2, one single and Hive Webcat service. So these are the services associated with this. And let's try to connect. So I'm using a beeline connectivity. So beeline. Then I need to use this connection string connect JDBC colon Hive 2. So the IP or the host name of the machine where Hive server 2 is running. So I can use this one. And I have to use the port. So by default, Hive server is running on 10,000. If it is using some other port, you need to use that. Also from the configuration, Cloudera manager configuration, you can easily find out those port. Then that is the database. So default. Then it will ask for the username and password, provide that. Suppose if it's Kerberos enabled, then it won't ask. You just need to key in it with that user. So I have connected with this Hive service and this is the Hive server 2 IP and the port. Then let me type one command show databases, right? So it will list all the databases. I have default and training here. So I'm just going to shut down this service, Hive Metastore server. Just stop that service for some time. Okay, so Hive Metastore server is stopped. Then, okay, so this is in stop state. Come back to here and to show database. If you type, then it won't execute and it will throw an error like this, right? So that is because my Metastore service is down. Then let me start it again and execute the query. Okay, so I just started that service back and Hive Metastore server is back. And then again, if I do show database, it will work. So here my intention is to just show you if I stop the service or if the service stopped due to any reason, then our Hive server will become unavailable. So user won't be able to access the Hive service. So in order to make this high available, so I'm mainly focusing on Hive Metastore server here. So we can configure high availability for this service. So that I will show you now. Okay, let me go to the Hive configuration. Hive configuration. Then select Metastore. Delegation. Token, one second. So Metastore delegation token store. So this is by default memory token store. So I'm just changing to DB token store. This is the parameter. You just need to change hive.metastore.delegation token store, change it to the DB token store. Then save that change. Okay, so now go to the instance. Okay, so it's asking for a restart, so let me restart this tail service. So redeploy. the service. Okay, so just restarted the service, go to the Hive service, go to the instance, then add a role instance. I'm going to add a couple of more Hive Metastore server here. So after changing the configuration, I'm just going to add. So here, so one is already selected, so I'm selecting two more. Okay, so you need to select this host based on your host selection criteria, but here I don't have much option, so I have only four machines, one master and three. So I'm adding two more instances, right? So you can add multiple also, but I'm just selected three and continue. Okay, so Metastore server port, so selecting the default, finish. Okay, so this is again showing like running with outdated configuration. So let me just redeploy that. Right, so the outdated, why it is showing like this configuration is outdated earlier, because Hive Metastore URIs. So I have only one Metastore service, so that was running on 240 server. So now added two more. I mean, along with the 240, I will have two more. I mean, the total I will have three servers for this Hive Metastore URIs. So I'm just restarting that and redeploying the client configuration. Okay, so restarted the service. Then go to the Hive, then go to the instances. Okay, so one Metastore service is not started. So let me try to troubleshoot that. Just trying to restart that Metastore service. Okay, so this service is not starting up. So what I need to do, I can get a more detailed log from this server. So let me log into that, and there is a file, log file. So we can just log into /var/log/hive and read that log file. And for getting the latest log, see here you can see this looks like something like the connectivity issue. See, you can see the driver not found exception. So in my case, it is connecting with the MySQL database, so I need to make sure like MySQL is up and running. Yes, that is up and running. Why? Because the other Metastore services are able to connect. So this problem could be because of JDBC driver not available in this machine. I can copy the JDBC driver, Hive JDBC driver, from other machines to here, or I can install that JDBC driver. MySQL hyphen connector . Okay, so I have installed that package, and let me try to restart the service again. Right, after installing the driver, I am able to start. So this time I have three Hive Metastore. So adding Hive Metastore server, high availability is very easy. Just you need to change this configuration. So Hive Metastore delegation token store to this DB store. And then restart and add a couple of more Hive Metastore server component. So now we will test this using the similar okay, I think I need to disconnect and connect again. Okay, right, so okay, so I'm able to execute my command. So let me try to stop one. Okay, so I'm just stopping this one and we'll see the status. Okay, so this Hive Metastore service is stopped. So this is why I'm also it's working. So let me stop one more. Okay, so two I have stopped. Then again, if you type, yes, I'm getting. So if I stop this third one, I mean the last one, then the service become unavailable. Like okay, so the same time, let me start another one and try it. Okay, so let me start the last one. Okay, so I started the last one, and if I turn off the first one, okay. So again, if I go back here and try to execute the command, it should work. That means, so we have three. If anyone, okay, if third one also, last one also goes down, then we will not be able to execute. That means in a Hive Metastore server service, if any one of the services is up and running, so we would be able to execute. This time, so nothing is running, so all the three are down, so the service won't be available, right? So I was getting this error. So if any one of the service, say for example, if service is started, then I would be able to access the service. So this makes sure like the service is have available even in case of any one of Hive Metastore server service failure. Okay, so I am just starting any one in the middle one and will check the connectivity again. Okay, so started this one. I mean now it's running on 33, and if I try show database, it's working. So here it's very easy. Hive Metastore server high availability is very easy. We can add the service. Only thing we need to do is just change the configuration Hive Metastore delegation token store to this value, so that you can change from Hive configuration Hive Metastore delegation search in the search tab, and you have to change it to DB token store. The default was memory token store, so that I changed to DB token store. Then after that, you can keep adding Hive Metastore server service. So that's it about Hive Metastore server service high availability. So if you have any questions or any clarity required, so please use the comment box. Also, if you like the content, so please click the like button and subscribe my channel if you have not already done, so that you will be getting notification from my channel. Thank you. Bye.